So now my jute pouch looks absolutely gorgeous and it looks absolutely beautiful. It's really wet because I have just finished doing this video and I'm super happy. I'm super excited and I hope you will like this video. So let's get started. And yes, do not forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon so that you do not miss any update. And of course, for all the supplies, whatever I have used in this session, I have mentioned that in a comment description box below, so do check that. And let's start making this one and decorate a plain jute pouch, which is something like this from the back side, but from the front it looks absolutely gorgeous. So let's get started. So this is my beautiful plain pouches, and on this I'm going to use my decoupage napkin to add a little more design to it. So here I'm going to remove the extra pieces of the papers. So here I'm using my brush and water technique. This is a super easy technique with which you can easily remove the excessive designs or the parts of the napkins. Now using my heat gun, I'm drying this out and I'll remove the ply so that we can stick this napkin on our jute pouch. Now the quality of this jute pouch is absolutely good. So that's the reason I did not even have to put any of the backings inside, and my work was much easier and much more hassle free. Now while I'm just trying to arrange that how I'm going to have my napkins, once I've decided that, then I'm going to have my Mod Podge, and I'm going to make sure that I apply generous amount of Mod Podge so that my napkin sticks to my jute base really well. So like I mentioned, that the quality of this pouch is so good that it was much more easier for me to work with my napkins. Of course, while applying Mod Podge, you need to be a little careful because while applying on a jute surface, it should be absorbed really well, otherwise your napkins are not going to stick well. So here applying a generous amount of Mod Podge, and the Mod Podge which I'm using here is a matte finish Mod Podge. If you want to make your own decoupage glue, I have already done a video on that and I'm going to share that link down in the description box or at the end of the video. Now as I'm applying my Mod Podge on the base, after sticking my napkin, I'm even going to apply a coat of Mod Podge directly on my napkin also. Now this is a very crucial step. When your decoupage napkin is wet, you have to be really, really, really careful. Now here I could see that my base is so strong that I can do the Mod Podge work on the top of it. If you want, you can wait for some time, for half an hour, and then you can do the application of Mod Podge on the top of your napkin. So now once I'm done with this, then I will be using my heat gun to dry this up. Now with just a flat brush, I am going to use a bit of Mod Podge so that whatever the excessive napkin portions are there, I can just twist and turn it around my pouch only, and I did not want it to cut that at all, and this is going to look great. So before moving to the next step, we have to make sure that our pouch has dried out completely, the Mod Podge has dried out completely. So here I'm using my heat gun. If you don't have a heat gun, you can just let it dry for 2-3 hours. This is one of the very interesting part of decorating your jute pouches, is blending your colors with the stencils with your sponge topper. Now here I have a beautiful stencil and I'm using my varieties of chalk paint shades. So here I have picked up the shades like red, orange and pink. If you want, you can choose the colors as per your combinations, whatever you are using in your decoupage napkin. So you can choose the colors accordingly. Now chalk paints are really good when it comes to doing your decoupage work. Why? Because it just gives a so matte finish and it dries out so well that definitely you can make out the difference between the acrylic and the chalk paints, and that's the reason I always recommend to do your artwork with your chalk paints. And yes, of course, if you are a beginner, you can try it out with the acrylic colors because they are price friendly also, but definitely there is a huge difference in your acrylic colors and the chalk paints. Now with a flat brush, I have just added some water here and there, and I am going to smudge my colors. This is just to make sure that the color blends well on my jute bases and the napkin should be look like a printed thing on my base. Now I'm just mixing up all the pink and the oranges and the red color, and I will be blending the I'll try to blend it really well on all the corners and the knickknacks so that it looks beautiful. Now this is the one of the beautiful stamp which I have. This has a very broad and a very thick square patterns, the check patterns, and I'm going to do my stamping on this. Now when your jute base is wet, the designs are not very clear, but let it settle down for 2-3 hours and then you can see all your stamping and your stencil work clearly. So here I'm using all the same chalk paints and I'm just doing a bit of stamping work. Now this is a really fun technique, but you just need to make sure that the moment you are done with your stamping work, you immediately dip that in a bowl of water or a plate of water. Now at last I am sealing my project with a varnish, and this has to be really generous, and yes, with this we are done. After varnish you need to let it dry for one day. Yes, now this is done and I really hope that you all enjoyed this session. If you guys have any query, please feel free to comment below. I will be more than happy to help you all. And yes, today what we did was loads of technique on color blending, doing the stencil work, and yes, during the process you might find out that the stencil work is not looking good or it is not coming out that well, but for let it dry completely. So like, can you see this portion? Initially you have this feeling that the designs are not visible, but see, the designs are really visible. It starts coming out really well once it starts drying out. So yes, and I hope you all enjoyed this tutorial. If you guys have any query, please do comment below, and do not forget to subscribe to our channel and hit the bell icon so that you do not miss any of the updates. Thank you so much for watching, guys. Take care. Bye bye. Passé.